Start recording. Okay, so here I am. What did I do? As you can see, I'm in a moment in Ubuntu, and I purely do this because I installed something in VirtualBox, which runs nice also on my free or GhostBSD installation. So it's OpenIndiana, and there are some rules. So if you want to run OpenIndiana, there are some people that just put 2 GB on. Ouch! Hit my thumb here with my tool. I kill myself here all for that video. No. So, display, I just give it 32. I think that's fine. But I had to give the system at least 4 GB RAM. I had it on 2 GB because I saw other people's videos and said, if the 2 GB will do. Yeah, if you just fire up the system and do not open Firefox, because then it freezes. Yeah, it just doesn't have enough RAM. So when Firefox opens up, it's going ballistic. So I'll show you how it looks like with 4 GB. So I make it a big window. And so there's some little rules. Also, I'm running it in a virtual box. And if you think you can install it with the VirtualBox additions ISO file, think again. I tried. This is for 5.1.28, what I used, I think. And I tried, and all I got was on the end that it said something like PostScript didn't get ended with error. So on the end, nothing really got installed, nothing really got executed, so no video drivers, no VM shared folder. In short, nothing. I had a nice look-like installation with nothing coming out. It's just what it is, right? So I'll show you a way how to install then the additions. It's actually much easier than you would think. You don't need that ISO file. It's so easy. So any moment. And I must say the booting speed, everything seems to be the same on FreeBSD or GhostBSD 12 or 19.09. If that ever shows up, you know, I'm talking about speed here and you don't see much, right? Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Doink! So that's good that I muted this. Nobody could hear my super secret, powerful NSA safe password. So, as you can see, Dren, I have the VirtualBox drivers installed. And by the way, I left something here in the trash can. Look how that looks really, really nice. I'm not a Mate fan, but it doesn't look too bad. I just have to get used to it, right? Like everything else. I have a few complaints, of course. So here first, VM share. Oh, the folder content could not be displayed. You do not have the permissions necessary to view the content. Well, but what I can do, if I open up Orville, where's my computer? And let's say, do I have something in downloads? Me, nothing, 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 nothing. Okay, what I could do, I open up something in data. You get something transfer. Bookmarks, yeah, just look, use this. So I just copy it over here. And then I go into one back. Let's say here, I'll put that in here. And there it is. So you see, I can, like, the same like with MX, I can copy and paste stuff on my network attached storage. I do believe it will make no difference when I run it on hardware. And I'm working on it. It's going to be. It's just I have one of these more modern computers, which are more like laptops, so you can't really add any SATA drives anymore. It has a solid-state drive and a small SATA drive, and this is it. And if that would be a normal computer box, I could just add on stuff, and that would be great. On the other hand, if you want an HDMI KVM switch, that is expensive. You almost can buy another computer for it, but I'm working on it. I will find something. So, if you go on HTOP, I installed HTOP, so by the way, it uses 1.6 GB. Uh, And it looks almost at this running Kaya. I don't know what it's doing in the background, but just imagine this. 1.6 gigabyte. So no surprise, when I had 2 gigabytes and I fired up Firefox, that was a no-no. It fired up with a white page and it never filled up and it never did anything, as you can see. So that's not what I've got no choice. There is no other browser, at least I haven't found it. So if you want to check, so you could actually play YouTube videos. You play YouTube videos? So you could play YouTube videos. What the heck? What is it doing? Where's my H-top? So I've no clue what it's doing, but it's working hard here in the background. I do not believe it's working hard on my real system. Oh. Yeah, it's doing something. Okay. It's pulling quite some power here, right? So let's see. We need something with sound, I guess. What do we look? Chris kidnapped, a new guy walked into blah blah blah. What do we have here? Oh, there's some serious banking. Ah, no, that's something different. Some bending here. Pretend to be BFFs. That looks like poison. Oh, plastic surgery. Do you want to see something disgusting? No, not really, no. So let's see what we have. Clean vines for your good Christian Minecraft server. Oh, no. Let's check something like that. Is there sound? So yeah, you can hear the sound, I hope.
I just want a spoiler-free evening.
Oh, this is so nice from your view. Doink. Uh-oh. Hold it! Wow! Oh, dear me. So, however, you can hear the sound, I guess. So I click that away. But it seems to be very strong on resources. Now it's on 1.3. Right? So if... Oh, yeah, look, that's weird. It's on 1.3. If I fire Firefox up again, let's see what I got now. 1.5. Oh, yeah. It could also be that it's expanding the hard drive, right? Because I used the virtual disk... What is it called? Dynamic volume. So what can we look? Oh, we had this one right here. Here it is again. Hey, yo. Yeah, but it seems to be doing okay. I mean, look at it, takes really quite some power here, right? Let me have a look. Oh, I might get a strike here, right? For being naughty. Okay, it takes quite some power here. I have no idea how it will look like on real hardware. So, but this is in Open Indiana. So, if we go Open Indiana here. Open Indiana. Oh, hold on. One day I learned typing, but not now. You can't have everything in one day. Oh, yeah, how did I do the virtual... Community packages. How did I do the virtual box drivers and stuff like that? Quick start, PKG publisher. To add publisher to your system requires privileges. Publisher, okay. Hipster, I think that's all there, right? I mean, I can't really tell ya. Let's click on something here. Search. Is it showing anything? No. Oh yeah, here's something VirtualBox. Okay. So you see, that would have been easy here. Yeah, I could have gone here. Oh no, you see, I did different. install. See, I didn't use that. What I used the terminal, and my command was sudo bash. Then I put my super secret NSA password in. Here it is. That's what I tried first. So I inserted the VirtualBox additions disk, copied it into my home folder. I think it's still there. Yeah, here. So I copied that thing, fired it up, package art, VBox, allows blah, blah, blah. And it pretends to install nice, and then you get an error for couldn't do the post-installation script and blah, blah, blah. So what I used is, it's pretty simple. It's here, it's like package. Then I used search, and I searched for VirtualBox. Oh, the other box. And then additions. Or addition, I can't say. We will see. If we can't find anything, then it's addition. So VirtualBox additions 6. Did I install 6 actually? I might have done it. Yeah, I think I just installed a VirtualBox addition. Yeah, so I did the same thing here. And then I just put install instead of search, and it installed the addition, and it works. Does work. Of course, there could be a little hiccup, right? Not too sure, because I'm running VirtualBox 5.... Oh dear me, how does it look like? It's quite, oh dear me, it's quite resource hungry, isn't it? Dang, that's an i5 CPU, which is not that bad. I don't know how good or bad that video is working. Oh, it crashed, right? It did, aborted. Okay, well, we'll fire it up again. So, because I have to show you how, that's how I installed the, what's it called? The VirtualBox additions. And then I had access, I had my virtual drivers installed. You see the sound is working. I hope you heard it. Booting up, I don't know, you know, VirtualBox is to me not an indicator how the software or the operating system is running on real hardware, right? I mean, and they do not have that optimized, I guess, for a VirtualBox, because there would have been the VirtualBox drivers in, and they had didn't add them on, so they're not there. Is it interesting? Definitely 100% interesting to me. Sadly, they don't have a forum, but they have an IRC chat, and I think I get my feet wet with this too. I just have to get it on real hardware, and then I play around with it, because I would like to see if I run VirtualBox, can it run my Windows 7 VirtualBox machine. And how is it doing in general, right? I want to see what it does. Sadly, VirtualBox doesn't do nested. But, I mean, you see the CPU power. I would need, 100 core CPU to run it. But I can't tell you what is the problem. Why it needs so much power. Oh, this time it went down. Let's see. Yeah, but for now, I have no rights to get into my VM share folder. Access, I don't have the rights, which is pretty sad, isn't it? I want the right to have this. However, but I do have rights now to my folders. See, I have access to my NAS folders, and I can read write without any problems, stuff like that. That also worked on FreeBSD. I just booted back up in here, said, okay. But every time I had some trouble, like when Firefox didn't go, I said, oh, it might be a FreeBSD thing. So booted up in Ubuntu, same thing. Then I increased memory, and ran. All of a sudden, I could fire up Firefox. But Firefox seems to be very hungry on resources here, the way I see it. So VirtualBox, do we have hplib? Let's see, hplib, do we have something like that? Ooh, they have hplib. That is good. Let's see if I can... Oh, I hate that very much. I'll call them back later. I'll call them now. They will be gone. So, however, so they have HP lib. Let me click that away. HP lib, then do they have scan to PDF? I don't know if the scan software will be supported. No, scan to PDF is not there. Simple. Scan, is that there? No simple scan either. Scan in general, is there anything scan? Server storage, virus scan, what? Webalizer. So they have no scan software. Is that sane? Xen, yeah, they have something there, okay. What else? Do they have VLC? Nope. Let's add a star. Let's see if I get something with that. Nope. Do we have Libre? Just want to see. Oh, yeah, it works. So that's a good thing. Compies. Gnome themes. Mate. Zone. I do believe you can get LibreOffice installed. No. Oh, let's say boxes. Boxes. Gnome theme standard. Mate. Pretty asterisk documentation. No gnome boxes. Okay. You know. All right, so you can check actually what they have on packages and do some stuff. They do have VirtualBox 6. I couldn't find Chromium, the browser, because I really, really do not Chromium BSU Bash competition. You see, web, oh, browser. I don't know if that works. Oh. Can it find two words? No, cannot. Let's try browser. Okay, here's something. What do I have? Viewers, X11 browser, Lynx, Firefox, ooh, E-Lynx viewer. By the way, that's the 64-bit version I have here, yeah? So if you check here. So that's, ooh, 60.9. Okay, that's a... I've got the 64-bit version here, so if you go into that, and I think you can say your name. Sun OS, Open India, 5.11, i386, i86 PC. Does that mean it is 32-bit? It is a 64-bit. I'm very, very, yeah, here, 64-bit. It is a 64-bit version. Okay, so, yeah, so how I installed it, I just went, what the heck is going on here? People are texting me. Oh, dear me. So, yeah, I got business here, which is good. But just to finish this off, so what I did is I used package... I know, I showed you this, yeah? So I installed it. So I used package. No, it's already there. I used sudo bash. Doink. Got in there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Package add. That didn't work. Then I went into package search. VirtualBox. Oh, I can make it small, I guess. VirtualBox. Additions. And I got back, there it is. So I just, what I did then, I didn't address anything. I just said, instead of search, I said install without the S in front. And then it worked. Yeah, it installed it. And then I rebooted and duran! I had my full screen and everything was working, which is very nice, isn't it? Yeah, so much for Open Indiana. I like it, actually. I must say I like it. I really do think it's... you see, now since I have no more such a strong limitations, like the limitations I had was I needed to have scanner work. It's scanned to PDF. Oh, yeah, so it seems to like crashing in the VirtualBox. But that doesn't mean anything. Windows 7 does that too, you know, or freezing, crashing. It's one or the other. I trust it's about VirtualBox is giving me a hard time. So what I'm going to do is I will fire it up in... I don't know if I have still my gear on, my GR7, because they use VirtualBox 6. And then I can give it a shot from there. So I'm just interested to keep a long story short. There, you definitely will see Open Indiana again. I will try to put it on real hardware because I really want to see how it works. And my next video is a little bit about my experience about FreeBSD. I had a gentleman, one of my subscribers, and that, you know, when I say subscribers, you're part of the channel, you know, there's no Patreon, blah, blah, blah. You're all working with me here. So he said, that is Dimdop. And he said, hey, BSD never tried it. How is the speed responsiveness? I must say, very nice. You don't feel a difference, or I don't feel a difference to Linux. And I used MX18, which is very snappy, or Ubuntu, which is not too bad. Did you install Wine? No, I did not, and I didn't test games yet. But I do have the NVIDIA driver installed, and it was very simple with GhostBSD. I don't have non-free codecs on, I think. I can't really say. It depends if GhostBSD puts them on, because I didn't add anything. Then tax action. I wonder what you have to say about Microsoft and Richard Stallman. Yeah, there is a video coming. Trust me, guys. I got to do it. I burn my tongue, most likely, but I cannot hold it back. I cannot hold it back. So, I just wanted to introduce Open Indiana. Oh, you know what? Everybody shows you how nice Open Indiana looks without the VirtualBox add-ons installed and all that stuff. And then they open some useless, or not useless, tiny applications which don't do anything. So they would have never figured out that 2 GB is really not enough to open Firefox, for example. So what I did is when Firefox didn't work, it froze, got it closed, and then I opened Thunderbird, and yeah, that worked. I said, okay, so memory problem most likely. So I just increased the memory, and to 4 GB, that worked out very nice. So, I mean, to be honest, guys, for us nowadays, most computers have a minimum of 8 GB, right? Even if you have 4, you will be fine. So, yeah, my laptop has 16 GB, my PC has 8. I don't see any problems when they take more memory nowadays. I still do have a 4 GB laptop and the Asus, not Asus, forgot what it was. Yeah, however, and I will run it maybe there to give it a shot to see how it looks like. And I just wanted to show you guys, I haven't done it, I wanted to do it with you, so I didn't dare to look without you, so I wanted to see what are they actually using as a file, file system. What file system do they use? You know, we use GhostBSD, no, uses UFS. So I would like to know, and they do have, watch it, they have, somewhere they have Gparted. And that is amazing. Here's Gparted, look at this. Can you imagine this? They have Gparted. No, FreeBSD doesn't. Yes, they do, but no GUI. Oh, no, I don't want to change my password. Screw you. That's sort of the bad thing, what they do, right? They try to force you to do things. So here it goes, you see. Issue with password. Password for user has expired. New password. Because they want letters in it. I hate it. It's none of their business. How do I my passwords? Solaris. So there is a formatting partition. Oh, kaboom. So there's a Solaris partition. That is interesting. I did not know this exist. So there it is. So I did not know that there's a thing like a Solaris partition. Look at this. So I have no clue what it does. But you see, they call it almost like BSD. Oh, it's Unix, right? It's more Unix-like than Linux in a moment. And so that's what they do. So that's very interesting to me. Device information, what does it tell us? MS-DOS, okay. Partition tables MS-DOS. No pending. Total sectors, cylinders. Okay. All right. This is what it is. But so now you know there is a thing, a file system called Solaris. I did not know it exists. I don't know if it can be mounted in Linux, for example, or in BSD. I mean, BSD seems to have trouble to mount lots of things, at least rewritable. It's all a little bit tricky. But in my opinion, this is a one-off. You have to figure it out, and then it works. And you just have to keep running and see if it does it after every update. But FreeBSD is not updating like crazy. And as much as I understand, OpenIndiana is definitely not crazy in updating either. What I appreciate, I actually like a system when it runs long, like CentOS or CentOS, you know. So I like it. I do like it a lot. I would like to see it on real hardware. I do have limitations now with my PC. What can you do, right? I will see. I definitely will have a look. I can't wait. Okay, guys, so that is that video about OpenIndiana. Don't try the addition disk, the ISO file. It is not working on VirtualBox. Just go into package. It's like Debian almost, you know, package pkg. Search install. That's how easy it is. Just do it that way, and you can actually see it in a full screen and play around a little bit. And I do believe that the VirtualBox crash is due to my VirtualBox here. There's something off. That's why Windows 7 doesn't work and all these weird things. Don't forget, you need a minimum of 4 GB RAM if you want to open something like Firefox. It seems to be the only browser available for OpenIndiana, which is totally terrible set. It's almost like installing some Microsoft product to me. Because they did it once, you know, who knows when they do it again. They hacked other people's computer, diverted their search, added things on and stuff like that. And that is a big, big break of trust and intruding privacy. Should have never happened. Shame on them. However, this is it. I hope you like that video a little bit. I don't have a radio voice, but I showed you at least the file system, right? And I told you how to put that VirtualBox addition on, because that's the only way it worked for me. The ISO file did not. So, next video will be again in FreeBSD, and I have to text somebody back, you know, money making money, money, money. Let me subscribe, blah, 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 bells and things like that. And here's my sponsor. The sponsor name is Give Me Your Money. And if you book the premium account, it is Give Me Your Money, all of it. And okay, there's no money. There's no money involved. Have a good night, guys. A good day, good night. I hope you like that video a little bit. I'm very, very excited about OpenIndiana. I'm really, really, really excited. I know that lots of people like to use it as a server, which I can imagine is a good idea. Yeah, definitely. It's Unix, right? It's Unix. It's like Linux, like BSD. It's definitely good. And I'm excited. I will definitely play around with it, but I do need hardware. You know, VirtualBox, yeah, it's nice to have a quick look, but you can't really say anything about the operating system if it's not running on Metal. That's my opinion. Rule number one, I'm always right. That means my opinion is the right one. And if you disagree, rule number one will be enforced, and then we are friends again. Okay, guys, this is it. I hope you like it. I will upload that video, and then I text and make money. Okay, guys, then I'll maybe buy some hardware. Woohoo! Okay, have a good night. See you all. Love you. Bye 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 bye.